vindt hij absoluut glorious up in here. As we look at the team, I don't know what you know, consequence in this part of the world. They've been talking about this one for a while, and they have rolled up to it in fantastic numbers. Chelsea rode outside the ground in the hour two leading up to it. It has been bumper to bumper, the traffic has been extraordinary, but the level of expectation is also very, very high. And these supporters who were queuing around the block for their tickets as soon as we knew the date of the fixture, well, now they can't wait for it to begin. And begin it will, any second now. And we have in front of us this gloriously imposing arena, absolutely picture perfect for a game of this nature. Two high-profile, high-caliber teams. This is a welcome event for all these supporters. Yes, Dieter, it's a shame it's only a friendly, but then again, that may help us see a more expressive attacking contest. And I'd be prepared to settle for a clash of lesser intensity in favour of lots of flair, skill, and plenty of tricks, and a few goals. I suspect I've probably overstretched my level of greed here. The action has already started. So who do you reckon is pivotal?
Yeah, Marc-Andre Ter Stegen. He's got everything you'd want from a top-level keeper. Great shot-stopping, but also a very cool head and a good organiser. What's more, he's very happy to play sweeper-keeper behind that defence, mopping up loose balls before picking a pass and get his team on the front foot again.
Yeah, he's getting the best out of him, will count for so much. Messi, he's out to the flank. Which has gone that so far. Driving on now, what can they conjure from here? Leg back in. It's gone through.
They are toying with their opponents.
Well, they know that their version of what they do is extremely good, and it's a level of possession that leaves the opposition chasing shadows. Extra good defending, but decisive passing. No progress. Now it's Griezmann.
Messi.
Griezmann. It's Griezmann! He's needing to be better than that, and he knows it. Messi. Chance. In with a header! Well, he's got that, and he knows it. Griezmann certainly could have, and should have, been more of that. Benfica still without an attack on target. Now it's Seferovic. He's in! And he's on his way! That has been kicked away. And it's Konat. And he's onside! He's got it and he's got time! Well, offside that time. He's got good distance on that. And the football is intercepted.
Messi.
He's through. Now it's Griezmann.
Griezmann.
He is not one readily to admit defeat. Don't be surprised if he tries that again. Well, the further he went, the more attention he attracted. There was just way too much pressure for him to get the shot away. So he sit forward. Very well to intervene. That's gone a long way up and away. If he can get it back, and they can go again. Now it's Seferovic. It's Seferovic. No effort at goal. I'm struggling to remember the last time we had that. They're heading no further forward. Still here, still. Nil-nil. We're already into the second period. Tight on game so far. Can that change now? Jordi Alba. And here's Griezmann. Jordi Alba. Jordi Alba delivers. He's gone for it! And the ball's got loose! Konat. He's picked it out. He's coming hard. Konat has been the subject of some adhesive marking. Well, they've got to deny him time and space, and that's one way of ensuring it. If you can take an extended half-time break, you'll be relieved to hear that you have missed nothing. Piqué. Longue. Longue drives it forward. They've been denied a chance to develop any rhythm in the passing department. And he has been fouled there. He apologies that he should have come up with something better there.
Oh, that just required a bit more oomph to reach its target.
Let down by a lack of accuracy. Trying to play it through. Yeah, the idea was right. The delivery wasn't. They can revisit that further on. And here's Griezmann. Griezmann really got caught in the trap there. And just didn't know. Piqué puts it to the right position to intercept. Lovely. Kelich. Won't move through and run into the second period. It is still anyone's game. Longley. Pjanic. Here it comes. Questions were asked. He's given the answers. Oh, he acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
It was too timid to make it through the defence. It'll be known to them. He'll prove the penalty.
Otamendi. Time for a throw-in. think it's the same, he was expecting a better ball than that. Tried to play it through. The movement was good, but the pass lacked a cause of mild frustration. And here's Messi. And he sets clear. Messi with a short one. That's a foul. Referee's given it. That was a slip move, and there were several options in the box for him to get out. Listen, it may well finish this way because it's been so tight all the way through, but equally, we might still get a moment of magic, a mistake, or a referee decision to influence otherwise. And it's Pjanic. Barcelona to make one last surge forward. I think that's a corner. Yes, it is. So here comes the substitution. The referee's seen the board, and he's going to allow a double change to go ahead now. Plays it back. DK. Ricky Pooch. To the left it goes. Battles to win it back. You wonder if that's it now, but there may be one more opportunity, Peter, for a late steal here. They're playing as if time is on their side when it's fast running out. They've got to quick in the side.
There goes the final whistle. Look at the fairway out. The craft of fire, penetration. It's large and untroubled.
Perhaps one team might be happier, but at the final reckoning, it's honours even and no complaints.
Well, thanks for your company, Jim, and a very good day to you.